the series about the death of Trayvon Martin. That was Monday night that it came out, and, you know, getting a lot of attention.
It just polarized the country.
We were overcome with fear and anger.
Trayvon became the face of our community. We had to go to war for him.
This is what's produced by Jay-Z. It's a 6-part documentary, and it looks into the final moments of Trayvon Martin's life when he was gunned down by George Zimmerman in 2012, and then the public outcry and the movement that followed. One episode in, people already say they're moved. Here's some of the reaction from online. I tried to watch the Trayvon Martin documentary. I couldn't relive that all over again. It's very intense. It's very real. They gather together a lot of footage. Another person says, I just watched Rest in Power and I have tears in my eyes. Injustice leads to destruction. That boy should still be alive. And although it's not being aired until in the UK until a little bit later in the year, this is one of the most important stories being told, maybe in our lifetime. The Trayvon Martin story began yesterday in the US and it is heartbreaking.
Yeah, it's really one of those stories that is a trigger for so many people, right? Because there are so many African-American people, not just in the States, but even across the world, who lived this same experience that Trayvon has gone through. Some have made it out alive, some have not. And those wounds, sometimes they don't heal, especially if you, if you don't get the treatment that you need, the mental help that you need, and you just have to continue to live your life because those supports are not there. Mm-hmm. So when you watch something like this, it's very hard because you go through that. But we have to remember that after this in 2012, this is what led to the Black Lives Matter movement. Mm-hmm. And that changed the game for so many things. But I always remember when that movement came out and the critics and the people against it tried to say, well, that movement was racist because it wasn't All Lives Matter. And it was so astonishing to hear that because it was a community that was trying to come together to fight for the lives of the young men in that community. Mm-hmm. And the world came out against, many people in the world came out against saying, you shouldn't be doing that. And all I could remember is that on social media, there was this one post that said, you know, when you go to a cancer fundraiser, do you run in and say, oh, what about Alzheimer's?
Right.
So anyways, it's a situation that I hope gets better. But again, we continue to see things happen over and over and over again. And it's not just the Black community, but also the Indigenous community that faces this type of systemic issues as well.